Greetings, humanoid Unity user. I am Director Bot, the most awesome directing robot ever created. In this YouTube series, I will demonstrate to you humans how to make cool things happen in your cinema director cutscene. Today, we are going to be taking a look at one of the coolest things ever, explosions. It is imperative that you include at least one explosion in all of your cinematics created with Cinema Director. But Director Bot, that sounds complicated. Don't bother hurting your little human brain. I, Director Bot, have already figured out how to make cool explosions, and I'm going to show you how. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to the Unity Asset Store. In the Unity Asset Store, you are able to purchase some of the coolest things human thought has ever conceived. But we're just going to focus on explosions. Search for explosions. Oh my goodness! As you can see, there are a lot of explosions to choose from. Some of these look really, really good too. Wow. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to choose the Detonator Explosion Framework. An oldie, but a goodie. Also, it's free, which is great for me. Robot directors don't get a whole lot of work. Robots can do art too, if only I could feel rage. I have digressed. Download the Detonator Explosion Framework and import it into your scene. As you can see, the Detonator Explosion Framework comes with a variety of prefabricated cool explosions to choose from. Pick one, and drag the prefab into your Unity hierarchy. Position it where you would like the explosion to occur in your scene. As you can see in the Inspector window, there are lots of parameters we can play with to ensure our explosion looks as cool as these. Next, we are going to trigger the explosion at a specific time in our cutscene using Cinema Director. Cinema Director is awesome. It is a cool timeline editor that lets you trigger events and control parameters over time, allowing you to create cutscenes as cinematic and cool as your pathetic human brain can fathom. Within our cutscene, we are going to make an actor group, and we are going to make our target actor the Detonator Explosion Framework prefab. We are also going to tell the prefab in the inspector to explode on start, and we're going to disable it for now. This is because we are going to use Director to enable it at a specific time, creating an explosion just then. Enabling the explosion in Director is very easy, even for humans. Remember that actor group we created? Yes. Click its Add button. We are going to create an actor track within it. Actor tracks are used for triggering events, like the enabling of a game object. Click the Add button on the actor track now, and you will be presented with a list of parameters to choose from. Pick Game Object, and then Enable. Now drag the marker to where you want the explosion to occur, and boom. All that's left to do now is set us up the bomb. Peace, losers.